two of the greatest athletes of all time to play the game of basketball. Both who decided to skip college and enter the NBA draft at the age of 18.
Did you capture it? Just let it slip. Yo. His palms are sweaty, knees weak, arms are heavy, there's vomit on his sweater already.
They quickly became stars, setting the example for players for years to come. But then, everything changed.
They're playing basketball.
All around the world.
We are the basketball.
To the beach,
y'all. They're playing basketball.
Let's go. All around the world. Y'all know. This is so dead.
The one-and-done rule was implemented in 2005 by former NBA Commissioner David Stern and the Players Union through a collective bargaining agreement, as a result of an influx of players entering the NBA draft out of high school, trying to replicate LeBron and Kobe's path to stardom.
Now basketball is my favorite sport. I like the way they dribble up and down the court. I keep it so fresh on the microphone. I like no interruption when the game is on. I like slam dunk to take me to the hoop. My favorite play is the alley-oop. I like the pick and roll. I like the give and go. And it's basketball. Bow wow, let's go.
Every player that you just saw was required to attend college for at least a year thanks to the implementation of the one-and-done rule. The rule has good intentions of giving athletes an opportunity to mature before entering the pros, which is a sensible idea, but the rule has caused controversy and division amongst analysts and fans.
As a lifelong college basketball fan, I've had a lot of experience watching the one-and-done rule change over time and wanted to know more. This leads me to my research question. Is the one-and-done rule ruining college basketball?
Everyone seems to have an opinion on the one-and-done rule and how it's affecting college basketball, as well as any solutions that could be made to the rule to improve it or abolish it. In a recent article, Dan Green, an experienced writer from Sports Illustrated, addresses the recent news of another possible rule change that would make the eligibility age for 20 years old for the NBA. But Green believes that any more changes to the one-and-done rule would only further cripple college basketball. He suggests that it might be too much to ask for NBA-caliber high school athletes to spend a second year in college before entering the draft, therefore leaving a greater opportunity for injury. Washington Post columnist Jerry Brewer takes a more empathetic and human approach to his argument, saying that the criticism that surrounds the one-and-done rule comes with little regard for the actual athletes in question. He says, "Consider for once what's fair for the athletes who become adults, at least legally, at the age of 18, not just what seems right in utopia. He also states that since the rule was created 13 years prior, there have been 55 top 5 draft picks. 29 of them have been freshmen. He believes the NBA is torn between wanting young potential and not wanting athletes who are right out of high school in the league. This is a dilemma that, until unsolved, marks changing the rule unproductive." Finally, Matt Norlander, award-winning writer from CBS Sports, speaks on the positive impact that the one-and-done rule has had on college basketball. While he believes there's no perfect solution to the rule, Norlander takes the role of devil's advocate against college fans, saying that college basketball has benefited greatly from these once-in-a-generation athletes being forced to go to school for at least a year prior to the NBA. He concurs that any change to the rule would essentially ruin college basketball, sending ratings plummeting. One thing I realized while doing research on the one-and-done rule was that no article that I read asked the opinions of any fans, aka the people who provide money and make the industry of college basketball so successful. So I decided to conduct a survey asking fans three questions involving the one-and-done rule and have provided them in this video today. In my first survey question, how long have you been a fan of college basketball? 59.3% of people surveyed had followed it for over 20 years, while 11.1% respectively had followed it for 15 to 19 years and 9 to 14 years respectively, providing some credibility in their answers. In my second question for my surveyors, If a change were to be made to the one-and-done rule, what change, if any, would you like to see? 32% said abolish the rule, let athletes enter the NBA draft out of high school. While 20% said no change, players required to at least attend for 1 year, which is the current rule. And then 36% said extend the rule, players required to attend 2 years before college. Giving a nice array of mixed answers that I wasn't expecting. For my last question, I asked fans how the one-and-done rule had impacted their fan experience, and some of the responses I received were, obviously the rule has its benefits, but for the most part the rule has brought me much frustration as a fan. I have not liked all the roster turnover and clumping up absurdly dominant teams. The next one, while I believe that college education is very important, I am also understanding of the opportunity that if the person has the talent to succeed at the professional level, they should go to the professional level. The next answer, I like the one and done rule, because we get to see a lot of what players are capable of, without forcing them to age too much. Next, it is a disappointment to have a great player for a year to help advance the team, and then he's gone. There are talks of changes to the rule, but for now, it will remain the same. After this research, I'm personally torn on the matter and can see the damage and progress from both sides. But what do you think? Based on this video, do you believe the one and done rule is ruining college basketball? Thank you for watching. Go Cuse.